Good morning to all respected teachers, dear seniors, and my batchmates. Welcome, all of you. My name is Dr. Venkat Kumar, participation number 9. Online refresher course in disaster management conducted by Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, Marathwada University, Aurangabad. I am going to talk about meaning and effect of cascading under GST. My presentation includes a very brief introduction of GST law, major objectives of GST, types of events under GST, tax system before GST implementation, and tax system after GST implementation. At the end, we will see the pictorial presentation of cascade world. This will take approximately 5 to 8 minutes of yours. Please save the questions for the end of the talk. Now I will focus on the topic. Friends, as you know, GST stands for Goods and Services Tax. The slogan of GST is One Nation, One Tax and One Market. This act was commenced from 1st July 2017 all over India except Jammu and Kashmir. We know due to Article 370, this act was implemented in Jammu and Kashmir from 8th July 2017. The important word used in GST is supply instead of sale of goods or provision of services, etc. Basically, under GST, there are four types of taxes. Number one, CGST means Central Goods and Services Tax. Number two, SGST, State Goods and Services Tax. Number three, UTGST, that is Union Territory Goods and Services Tax. And fourth, IGST, that is Integrated Goods and Services Tax. Integrated means combination of two taxes, either CGST and or CGST and UTGST. Friends, look at this slide. There are various objectives of GST, but out of those objectives, the major objectives are to avoid cascading effect, benefit of input tax credit, reducing administrative complications, reducing the slab rates. Out of these objectives, we will focus on the object avoiding cascading effect. Friends, basically the tax are levied on events. Under indirect taxes, there are two types of events. Number one is isolated events. Isolated events means single event. For example, if we buy a movie ticket, only one person can use that ticket once a time. Second type is cyclic events. It means the events happens in a particular order, one following the other, and are often repeatedly. For example, movement of goods from manufacturer to wholesaler, wholesaler to retailer, a retailer to final consumer. The cascading effect can see in only cyclic events, not in the isolated events. Friends, look this picture. Here, before GST, what was happened? Suppose in supply chain, manufacturer 1 purchases a raw material of rupees 100 and makes some value addition of rupees 40 and add rupees 10 as a profit. For him, the total production cost is rupees 150 and the tax rate was 10% on these goods. It becomes 165 as a selling price for a manufacturer number 1. It means manufacturer 2 take rupees 165 as a purchase price in the books of accounts. After maybe making some value addition, the cost becomes rupees 215 for him. And including 10% of tax of rupees 21, the selling price becomes 236 for manufacturer number 2. In this way, the third manufacturer can add tax and sell the goods for rupees 350. It means finally goods were sold for rupees 350 for the final consumer. Friends, before GST, consider that the movement of goods occurs through four persons. In the first stage, tax was charged by four persons, person number 1, 2, 3 and 4. In second stage, tax was charged by the person number 2, 3 and 4 and so on. Now we will see after GST what is happened. In the same scenario, the selling price for first man is 165, but manufacturer 2 will take note of in the books of accounts as rupees 150 as purchase price and rupees 15 as GST. In this case, manufacturer 2 sell the goods to manufacturer 3 for rupees 220, out of which cost is rupees 200 and the amount of GST is rupees 20. But when manufacturer 2 pay the amount of GST to the government is rupees 5 only, because manufacturer 2 collect rupees 20 as GST from manufacturer 3, but due to input tax credit facility, the manufacturer number 2 can pay only 5 rupees, that is the difference between 20 and 15 to the government. When we compare the price of the goods, it shows that before GST, the cost of the same goods was rupees 350. And after GST, the cost is rupees 275. It means price is reduced by rupees 40. It happens only to avoidance of cascading effect under GST. Friends, basically the word cascade came from the waterfall. But there are a difference between waterfall and cascade. In waterfall, the water is directly fall on the earth, but in cascade waterfalls on earth, slowly, it means step by step. GST remove the effect of cascading, that is tax on tax. Thank you, my friends, for giving me an opportunity to introduce this concept before you. Thanks once again.